What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome back to another FIFA 21 video. It is 6 p.m. on Tuesday, and I am highly anticipating some guaranteed Team of the Season packs, probably from Turkish League, unfortunately. And I'm not really sure if we're going to get anything at all otherwise. But let's see what EA have given us for today. We'll go back to the object. Oh my God. Under 23. Oh my God. Why have we had so much more content for La Liga compared to Premier League? Like we're not talking a little bit more content. We are talking a whole bunch more content. There's no new icons. There's no new leagues. There is a Gerard Pique. This must be a throwback to his team of the year, right? No, his 17 team of the season. Wow. I mean, physically and defensively, insane. In fact, you don't need to boost up his defending. Probably boost up, like, give him a catalyst or something. Dribbling-wise, he's brilliant. Passing-wise, he's brilliant. Pace is where he suffers a little bit. High medium work rate, 6'4". Two segments needed. An 85 with a team of the season or team of the week. One Barcelona player and an 86. That is very, very reasonable. Very reasonable. That is very, very good. And then earn a La Liga under 23 team of the season moments. And a Baronet Zaya. Celebrating his superb inside the box goal against SD Eibar. Under 23s, you know. And this guy's got four-star. Look at those stats. 94 pace, 92 shooting in the right areas. Great positioning, great finishing, great shot power. He's got good stam, really poor aggression. Really poor reactions and composure for this stage of the game. And his passing's good. But in general, I love this concept. This is a really cool concept. We're going to have a look at what his like card was and how much they boosted him to. And then it's an 84 rated and an 85 rated. No informs needed. 60 chem and 65 chem. Brilliant. Just brilliant. PK, top class. What else have we got? More La Liga team of the season challenges. I haven't done any of those. 81, 82. Ooh, another 85 by 5 upgrade. And the guaranteed Super League team of the season upgrade. And I can't imagine that's going to be too expensive. The Super League tots. That's an 82 rated squad with 45 chemistry. We'll build and complete that in a second. But also the 85 by 5 is back again. And let's see. 86 rated. With one in form. My word. That's actually quite tough, that. 86 rated with an in form for an 85 by 5. We're going to build it. We're going to open it. 86 rated. Thank God the chemistry's low. There's an 87. I might struggle to put an 86 rated squad together. Oh no, there we go. We've got two more 87s there. We've got the 86 Kalinoglu, which helps massively. And then Rodri. Any more 85s? Yes, Koke. All right, we should be all right. Otherwise, I'll probably put in like a João Felix, I think. I'm genuinely impressed with this content though, guys. I can't lie. All right, that is already 86 comfortably. Let's get rid of an 87. No, let's get rid of an 86. No, let's get rid of an 85. Yes, right, that's ours done, the 5x85. But normal content creators off on holiday this week. It's crazy. Like once again, all of these players aren't going to be for everyone. Some people are going to see that PK and be like, no, don't want that, too expensive. Some people are going to see that left wing guy and be like, he's got some stats that are wrong. And you know, or not meta enough or whatever, like, you know, whatever we see there. But in general, EA have done a madness with this. So we need an 82 rated squad. We'll pop in some of these 83s since we know we'll pick up a whole bunch of these 83s going forwards. And we just need some chemistry and not a lot else. Put Valverde in there. Let's pop him over there. That's already the chemistry. How much for Super League Team of the Season Pack? Well, it's just an 82 rated with super low chemistry. So it's not expensive at all. Go in there. That's 81 rated. And he can go in there. That's 82 rated. So let's open these. Then let's go and jump onto Footbin and have a look at those two players, their price points, and how good they can be in game. So we'll start with a Super League Team of the Season. The only player I really want from here is Davidson. So Brazilian left wing would be ideal, please, EA. It's not. It's going to be the Cam. It, probably one of the worst, actually. Baka Setas, 3-star, 4-star. Just way too low this stage of the game. But hey, there it is. And then a 585 player pack. Come on, EA. Let's hook this up. Walk out. Team of the season. Come on. Be a big one for me, please. Cameroon striker. Okay, it's a Boubacar. It's a new one. It's not bad. He's also relatively high rated. There could easily be some more in here. There could be some more in here. Ooh, oh my God, there is. That's not bad. For an 85 by 5 pack, that's really good. Three team of the seasons in it. Okay, Aboubakar and Boyok, not exactly the best. You know, not exactly worth too much. 287s, which is real nice. And then Koundé, who unfortunately I already have as untradeable, but I can put him in PK. So that really isn't that bad. However, we are going to go ahead and have a look at these two players, Ander and PK. Oh man. So PK is what I'm interested to see. So they've given him 23 pace, 40 balance, and 24 agility, 16 stamina, no other standout points. You cut, like, a Shadow is stupid because his defense is already just too good. A Hunter is stupid because it's just stupid. A Catalyst might just be the one. 93, do you know what? I actually quite like an engine. With an engine, he's not quite as fast, but it boosts his dribbling up so nice. His defending is outrageous. His physicals are very good. It's a shame there's nothing. Do you know? Dare I say it? Dare I say it? But a Hawk on PK could be the one. It gives him a 5 pace boost, and then it gives him 9 aggression, 1 strength, and 10 jumping. For a man who's 6'4", right? 6'4". Having 94 jumping and 95 heading is actually not bad. His passing is very good for a centre-back. His dribbling is insane for a centre-back. His pace is the only problem, right? But if you play 5 at the back, or you play with either a Shadow or a Catalyst on him, it's not the worst. 93 sprint speed is still good. I think that this is a good card. It'd be interesting to see what his price is. Now, I'm interested to see what they gave this guy. 25 physicals. See, here's what I don't like, right? When we look at PK, look at his dribbling. They gave 40 balance, 24 agility, right? So even though they only gave 12 dribbling, they gave 40 balance. They now have the capabilities to do that. So when we look at this Ander card and we look at what he was, they gave him 13 pace, 26 shooting, 21 passing. They gave him 25 physical with a little bit extra stamina, and they gave him 6 defending. They only gave him 9 dribbling and only boost his reactions and composure by 9. Why not just boost those reactions and composure up to like the mid 80s, and now all of a sudden you've got yourself an insane card, which I don't think anyone would mind. He's 4-star, 4-star. He's got medium work rates, and he is in general very good. I think Maestro on him, you need to, maybe an engine on him, actually. That's what I would go with. Great pace, great agility, balance, and dribbling. Very, very good shooting, and very good passing with 92 stam. That's a quality card. That is a quality card. The only thing we're going to look at is How much are these going to cost if you're not somebody who grinds the game, right? So the Super League is coming in at 15K. That's cool. The 85x5 is 180. Very much downvoted, I think, because it's an 86 rated squad with an inform is very expensive for that. And then this Ander card, heavily downvoted. And PK, also downvoted. Wow. I'm really surprised. The whole point is, though, is he under 23s, so his reactions and composure isn't going to be maxed out yet. Yeah, but they've maxed out his shooting, his pace, and other dribbling stats. That argument just doesn't hold true at all, really. So we need an 85 and an 84 for Ander. And if we look at Cantona, he's got an 85 and an 84. So an 85 is 100-ish. And then an 84. Yeah, he's going to be about 150 for that card. That's all right. And then PK is PK worth it? I think so, man. PK is an 85 with an inform at 130 and an 86. The PK is going to be about 300K. And the other guy is going to be about 150-ish, maybe 160. With how much fodder's floating around, with how cheap things are, with how easy it is to grind the game right now, it's not bad at all. It's not bad. There's a lot of good stuff there. And then last but not least, it's just whether or not we actually got any new objectives. A new daily objective and that's it. I wish they did more with this. I just wish they did more with the milestone section. It's been, once again, completely underutilized. But guys, that is going to be the end of the video for today. If you did enjoy it, be sure to leave a like, rating, comment, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And for now, guys, I'm out. Peace.